And Isaac was 40 years old when he took Rebekah to wife, the daughter of Bethuel the Syrian of Padan Aram, the sister to Laban the Syrian. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife, because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah his wife conceived. And the children struggled together within her. And she said,
"If it be so, why am I thus?"
And she went to inquire of the Lord. And the Lord said unto her,
"Two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels. And the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger."
And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb. And the first came out red all over like an hairy garment. And they called his name Esau. And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau's heel, and his name was called Jacob. And Isaac was 80 years old when she bare them. And the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter, a man of the field. And Jacob was a plain man, dwelling in tents. And Isaac loved Esau, because he did eat of his venison, but Rebekah loved Jacob. And Jacob sawed pottage, and Esau came from the field, and he was faint. And Esau said to Jacob,
"Feed me, I pray thee, with that same red pottage, for I am faint."
Therefore was his name called Edom. And Jacob said,
"Sell me this day thy birthright."
And Esau said,
"Behold, I am at the point to die, and what profit shall this birthright do to me?"
And Jacob said,
"Swear to me this day."
And he sware unto him, and he sold his birthright unto Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and pottage of lentils, and he did eat and drink, and rose up and went his way. Thus Esau despised his birthright. Chapter 26. And there was a famine in the land, beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto Abimelech, king of the Philistines, unto Gerar. And the Lord appeared unto him, and said,
"Go not down into Egypt. Dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. Sojourn in this land, and I will be with thee, and will bless thee. For unto thee and unto thy seed I will give all these countries. And I will perform the oath which I swear unto Abraham thy father. And I will make thy seed to multiply as the stars of heaven, and will give unto thy seed all these countries. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because that Abraham obeyed my voice, and kept my charge, my commandments, my statutes, and my laws."
And Isaac dwelt in Gerar, and the men of the place asked him of his wife, and he said,
"She is my sister."
For he feared to say, "She is my wife."
"Lest,"
said he,
"the men of the place should kill me for Rebekah, because she was fair to look upon."
And it came to pass, when he had been there a long time, that Abimelech, king of the Philistines, looked out at a window, and saw, and behold, Isaac was sporting with Rebekah his wife. And Abimelech called Isaac and said,
"Behold, of a surety she is thy wife. And how saidst thou, she is my sister?"
And Isaac said unto him,
"Because I said, lest I die for her."
And Abimelech said,
"What is this thou hast done unto us? One of the people might lightly have lain with thy wife, and thou shouldest have brought guiltiness upon us."
And Abimelech charged all his people, saying,
"He that toucheth this man or his wife shall surely be put to death."
Then Isaac sowed in that land, and received in the same year 100-fold. And the Lord blessed him, and the man waxed great and went forward and grew until he became very great. For he had possession of flocks and possession of herds and great store of servants. And the Philistines envied him, for all the wells which his father's servants had digged in the days of Abraham his father, the Philistines had stopped them and filled them with earth. And Abimelech said unto Isaac,
"Go from us, for thou art much mightier than we."
And Isaac departed thence, and pitched his tent in the valley of Gerar, and dwelt there. And Isaac digged again the wells of water which they had digged in the days of Abraham his father, for the Philistines had stopped them after the death of Abraham. And he called their names after the names by which his father had called them. And Isaac's servants digged in the valley, and found there a well of springing water. And the herdmen of Gerar did strive with Isaac's herdmen, saying,
"The water is ours."
And he called the name of the well Esek, because they strove with him. And they digged another well, and strove for that also. And he called the name of it Sitna. And he removed from thence, and digged another well, and for that they strove not. And he called the name of it Rehoboth. And he said,
For now the Lord hath made room for us, and we shall be fruitful in the land.
And he went up from thence to Beersheba. And the Lord appeared unto him the same night, and said,
I am the God of Abraham thy father. Fear not, for I am with thee, and will bless thee, and multiply thy seed for my servant Abraham's sake.
And he builded an altar there, and called upon the name of the Lord, and pitched his tent there. And there Isaac's servants digged a well. Then Abimelech went to him from Gerar, and Ahuzzath one of his friends, and Phicol the chief captain of his army. And Isaac said unto them,
Wherefore come ye to me, seeing ye hate me, and have sent me away from you?
And they said,
We saw certainly that the Lord was with thee. And we said, Let there be now an oath betwixt us, even betwixt us and thee, and let us make a covenant with thee, that thou wilt do us no hurt, as we have not touched thee, and as we have done unto thee nothing but good, and have sent thee away in peace. Thou art now the blessed of the Lord.
And he made them a feast, and they did eat and drink. And they rose up betimes in the morning, and sware one to another. And Isaac sent them away, and they departed from him in peace. And it came to pass the same day that Isaac's servants came and told him concerning the well which they had digged, and said unto him,
We have found water.
And he called it Sheba. Therefore the name of the city is Beersheba unto this day. And Esau was 40 years old when he took to wife Judith the daughter of Beori the Hittite, and Bashemath the daughter of Elon the Hittite, which were a grief of mind unto Isaac and to Rebekah. Chapter 27. And it came to pass that when Isaac was old, and his eyes were dim so that he could not see, he called Esau his eldest son, and said unto him,
My son.
And he said unto him,
Behold, here am I.
And he said,
Behold, now I am old. I know not the day of my death. Now therefore take, I pray thee, thy weapons, thy quiver, and thy bow, and go out to the field, and take me some venison, and make me savory meat such as I love, and bring it to me, that I may eat, that my soul may bless thee before I die.
And Rebekah heard when Isaac spake to Esau his son. And Esau went to the field to hunt for venison and to bring it. And Rebekah spake unto Jacob her son, saying,
Behold, I heard thy father speak unto Esau thy brother, saying, Bring me venison and make me savory meat, that I may eat and bless thee before the Lord before my death. Now therefore, my son, obey my voice according to that which I command thee. Go now to the flock, and fetch me from thence 2 good kids of the goats, and I will make them savory meat for thy father, such as he loveth. And thou shalt bring it to thy father, that he may eat, and that he may bless thee before his death.
And Jacob said to Rebekah his mother,
Behold, Esau my brother is a hairy man, and I am a smooth man. My father peradventure will feel me, and I shall seem to him as a deceiver, and I shall bring a curse upon me, and not a blessing.
And his mother said unto him,
Upon me be thy curse, my son. Only obey my voice, and go fetch me them.
And he went and fetched and brought them to his mother. And his mother made savory meat such as his father loved. And Rebekah took goodly raiment of her eldest son Esau, which were with her in the house, and put them upon Jacob her younger son. And she put the skins of the kids of the goats upon his hands and upon the smooth of his neck. And she gave the savory meat and the bread which she had prepared into the hand of her son Jacob. And he came unto his father and said,
My father.
And he said,
Here am I. Who art thou, my son?
And Jacob said unto his father,
I am Esau, thy firstborn. I have done according as thou badest me. Arise, I pray thee, sit and eat of my venison, that thy soul may bless me.
And Isaac said unto his son,
How is it that thou hast found it so quickly, my son?
And he said,
Because the Lord thy God brought it to me.
And Isaac said unto Jacob,
Come near, I pray thee, that I may feel thee, my son, whether thou be my very son Esau or not.
And Jacob went near unto Isaac his father, and he felt him, and said,
The voice is Jacob's voice, but the hands are the hands of Esau.
And he discerned him not, because his hands were hairy as his brother Esau's hands. So he blessed him, and he said,
Art thou my very son, Esau?
And he said,
I am.
And he said,
Bring it near to me, and I will eat of my son's venison, that my soul may bless thee.
And he brought it near to him, and he did eat, and he brought him wine, and he drank. And his father Isaac said unto him,
Come near now, and kiss me, my son.
And he came near and kissed him, and he smelled the smell of his raiment, and blessed him, and said,
See, the smell of my son is as the smell of a field which the Lord hath blessed. Therefore God give thee of the dew of heaven, and the fatness of the earth, and plenty of corn and wine. Let people serve thee, and nations bow down to thee. Be Lord over thy brethren, and let thy mother's sons bow down to thee. Cursed be every one that curseth thee, and blessed be he that blesseth thee.
And it came to pass, as soon as Isaac had made an end of blessing Jacob, and Jacob was yet scarce gone out from the presence of Isaac his father, that Esau his brother came in from his hunting. And he also had made savory meat, and brought it unto his father, and said unto his father,
Let my father arise, and eat of his son's venison, that thy soul may bless me.
And Isaac his father said unto him,
Who art thou?
And he said,
I am thy son, thy firstborn Esau.
And Isaac trembled very exceedingly, and said,
Who, where is he that hath taken venison, and brought it me? And I have eaten of all before thou camest, and have blessed him. Yea, and he shall be blessed.
And when Esau heard the words of his father, he cried with a great and exceeding bitter cry, and said unto his father,
Bless me, even me also, O my father.
And he said,
Thy brother came with subtlety, and hath taken away thy blessing.
And he said,
Is not he rightly named Jacob? For he hath supplanted me these two times. He took away my birthright, and behold, now he hath taken away my blessing.
And he said,
Hast thou not reserved a blessing for me?
And Isaac answered and said unto Esau,
Behold, I have made him thy lord, and all his brethren have I given to him for servants, and with corn and wine have I sustained him. And what shall I do now unto thee, my son?
And Esau said unto his father,
Hast thou but one blessing, my father? Bless me, even me also, O my father.
And Esau lifted up his voice and wept. And Isaac his father answered and said unto him,
Behold, thy dwelling shall be the fatness of the earth, and of the dew of heaven from above. And by thy sword shalt thou live, and shalt serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have the dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck.
And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart,
The days of mourning for my father are at hand. Then will I slay my brother Jacob.
And these words of Esau, her elder son, were told to Rebekah. And she sent and called Jacob, her younger son, and said unto him,
Behold, thy brother Esau, as touching thee, doth comfort himself, purposing to kill thee. Now therefore, my son, obey my voice, and arise. Flee thou to Laban, my brother, to Haran, and tarry with him a few days, until thy brother's fury turn away, until thy brother's anger turn away from thee, and he forget that which thou hast done to him. Then I will send, and fetch thee from thence. Why should I be deprived also of you both in one day?
And Rebekah said to Isaac,
I am weary of my life because of the daughters of Heth. If Jacob take a wife of the daughters of Heth, such as these which are of the daughters of the land, what good shall my life do me?
Chapter 28. And Isaac called Jacob, and blessed him, and charged him, and said unto him,
Thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan. Arise, go to Padan Aram, to the house of Bethuel, thy mother's father, and take thee a wife from thence of the daughters of Laban, thy mother's brother. And God Almighty bless thee, and make thee fruitful, and multiply thee, that thou mayest be a multitude of people, and give thee the blessing of Abraham to thee and to thy seed with thee, that thou mayest inherit the land wherein thou art a stranger, which God gave unto Abraham.
And Isaac sent away Jacob, and he went to Padan-Aram unto Laban, son of Bethuel the Syrian, the brother of Rebekah, Jacob's and Esau's mother. When Esau saw that Isaac had blessed Jacob and sent him away to Padan-Aram to take him a wife from thence, and that as he blessed him, he gave him a charge, saying,
Thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan.
And that Jacob obeyed his father and his mother, and was gone to Padan-Aram. And Esau, seeing that the daughters of Canaan pleased not Isaac his father, then went Esau unto Ishmael, and took unto the wives which he had, Mahalath, the daughter of Ishmael, Abraham's son, the sister of Nebajoth, to be his wife. And Jacob went out from Beersheba, and went toward Haran. And he lighted upon a certain place, and tarried there all night, because the sun was set. And he took of the stones of that place, and put them for his pillows, and lay down in that place to sleep. And he dreamed, and behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said,
I am the Lord God of Abraham thy father, and the God of Isaac, the land whereon thou liest. To thee will I give it, and to thy seed. And thy seed shall be as the dust of the earth, and thou shalt spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. And in thee and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. And behold, I am with thee, and will keep thee in all places whither thou goest, and will bring thee again into this land. For I will not leave thee, until I have done that which I have spoken to thee of.
And Jacob awaked out of his sleep, and he said,
Surely the Lord is in this place, and I knew it not.
And he was afraid and said,
How dreadful is this place! This is none other but the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven.
And Jacob rose up early in the morning and took the stone that he had put for his pillows, and set it up for a pillar, and poured oil upon the top of it. And he called the name of that place Bethel, but the name of that city was called Luz at the first. And Jacob vowed a vow, saying,
If God will be with me, and will keep me in this way that I go, and will give me bread to eat, and raiment to put on, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then shall the Lord be my God. And this stone, which I have set for a pillar, shall be God's house. And of all that thou shalt give me, I will surely give the tenth unto thee.
Chapter 29. Then Jacob went on his journey, and came into the land of the people of the east. And he looked, and behold, a well in the field. And lo, there were three flocks of sheep lying by it. For out of that well they watered the flocks. And a great stone was upon the well's mouth. And thither were all the flocks gathered, and they rolled the stone from the well's mouth, and watered the sheep, and put the stone again upon the well's mouth in his place. And Jacob said unto them,
My brethren, whence be ye?
And they said,
Of Haran are we.
And he said unto them,
Know ye Laban, the son of Nahor?
And they said,
We know him.
And he said unto them,
Is he well?
And they said,
He is well, and behold, Rachel his daughter cometh with the sheep.
And he said,
Lo, it is yet high day. Neither is it time that the cattle should be gathered together. Water ye the sheep, and go and feed them.
And they said,
We cannot until all the flocks be gathered together, until they roll the stone from the well's mouth. Then we water the sheep.
And while he yet spake with them, Rachel came with her father's sheep, for she kept them. And it came to pass, when Jacob saw Rachel, the daughter of Laban, his mother's brother, and the sheep of Laban, his mother's brother, that Jacob went near, and rolled the stone from the well's mouth, and watered the flock of Laban, his mother's brother. And Jacob kissed Rachel, and lifted up his voice, and wept. And Jacob told Rachel that he was her father's brother, and that he was Rebekah's son. And she ran and told her father. And it came to pass, when Laban heard the tidings of Jacob his sister's son, that he ran to meet him, and embraced him, and kissed him, and brought him to his house. And he told Laban all these things. And Laban said to him,
Surely thou art my bone and my flesh.
And he abode with him the space of a month. And Laban said unto Jacob,
Because thou art my brother, shouldest thou therefore serve me for naught? Tell me, what shall thy wages be?
And Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah was tender-eyed, but Rachel was beautiful and well-favored. And Jacob loved Rachel and said,
I will serve thee 7 years for Rachel, thy younger daughter.
And Laban said,
It is better that I give her to thee than that I should give her to another man. Abide with me,
And Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed unto him but a few days for the love he had to her. And Jacob said unto Laban,
Give me my wife, for my days are fulfilled, that I may go in unto her.
And Laban gathered together all the men of the place and made a feast. And it came to pass in the evening that he took Leah his daughter and brought her to him, and he went in unto her. And Laban gave unto his daughter Leah Zilpah his maid for a handmaid. And it came to pass that in the morning, behold, it was Leah. And he said to Laban,
What is this thou hast done unto me? Did not I serve with thee for Rachel? Wherefore then hast thou beguiled me?
And Laban said,
It must not be so done in our country, to give the younger before the firstborn. Fulfill her week, and we will give thee this also, for the service which thou shalt serve with me yet 7 other years.
And Jacob did so, and fulfilled her week. And he gave him Rachel his daughter to wife also. And Laban gave to Rachel his daughter Bilhah, his handmaid, to be her maid. And he went in also unto Rachel, and he loved also Rachel more than Leah, and served with him yet 7 other years. And when the Lord saw that Leah was hated, he opened her womb, but Rachel was barren. And Leah conceived and bare a son, and she called his name Reuben, for she said,
Surely the Lord hath looked upon my affliction. Now therefore my husband will love me.
And she conceived again, and bare a son, and said,
Because the Lord hath heard that I was hated, he hath therefore given me this son also.
And she called his name Simeon. And she conceived again, and bare a son, and said,
Now this time will my husband be joined unto me, because I have borne him 3 sons.
Therefore was his name called Levi. And she conceived again, and bare a son, and she said,
Now will I praise the Lord.
Therefore she called his name Judah, and left bearing. Chapter 30. And when Rachel saw that she bare Jacob no children, Rachel envied her sister and said unto Jacob,
Give me children or else I die.
And Jacob's anger was kindled against Rachel, and he said,
Am I in God's stead, who hath withheld from thee the fruit of the womb?
And she said,
Behold my maid Bilhah, go in unto her, and she shall bear upon my knees, that I may also have children by her.
And she gave him Bilhah, her handmaid, to wife, and Jacob went in unto her. And Bilhah conceived and bare Jacob a son. And Rachel said,
God hath judged me, and hath also heard my voice, and hath given me a son.
Therefore called she his name Dan. And Bilhah, Rachel's maid, conceived again, and bare Jacob a second son. And Rachel said,
With great wrestlings have I wrestled with my sister, and I have prevailed.
And she called his name Naphtali. When Leah saw that she had left bearing, she took Zilpah her maid, and gave her Jacob to wife. And Zilpah, Leah's maid, bare Jacob a son. And Leah said,
A troop cometh.
And she called his name Gad. And Zilpah, Leah's maid, bare Jacob a second son. And Leah said,
Happy am I, for the daughters will call me blessed.
And she called his name Asher. And Reuben went in the days of wheat harvest, and found mandrakes in the field, and brought them unto his mother Leah. Then Rachel said to Leah,
Give me, I pray thee, of thy son's mandrakes.
And she said unto her,
Is it a small matter that thou hast taken my husband? And wouldest thou take away my son's mandrakes also?
And Rachel said,
Therefore he shall lie with thee tonight for thy son's mandrakes.
And Jacob came out of the field in the evening, and Leah went out to meet him, and said,
Thou must come in unto me, for surely I have hired thee with my son's mandrakes.
And he lay with her that night. And God hearkened unto Leah, and she conceived, and bare Jacob the 5th son. And Leah said,
God hath given me my hire, because I have given my maiden to my husband.
And she called his name Issachar. And Leah conceived again, and bare Jacob the 6th son. And Leah said,
God hath endued me with a good dowry. Now will my husband dwell with me, because I have borne him 6 sons.
And she called his name Zebulun. And afterward she bare a daughter, and called her name Dinah. And God remembered Rachel. And God hearkened to her, and opened her womb, and she conceived and bare a son, and said,
God hath taken away my reproach.
And she called his name Joseph, and said,
The Lord shall add to me another son.
And it came to pass, when Rachel had borne Joseph, that Jacob said unto Laban,
Send me away, that I may go unto mine own place and to my country. Give me my wives and my children, for whom I have served thee, and let me go. For thou knowest my service which I have done thee.
And Laban said unto him,
I pray thee, if I have found favor in thine eyes, tarry. For I have learned by experience that the Lord hath blessed me for thy sake.
And he said,
Appoint me thy wages, and I will give it.
And he said unto him,
Thou knowest how I have served thee, and how thy cattle was with me. For it was little which thou hadst before I came, and it is now increased unto a multitude. And the Lord hath blessed thee since my coming. And now when shall I provide for mine own house also?
And he said,
What shall I give thee?
And Jacob said,
Thou shalt not give me anything. If thou wilt do this thing for me, I will again feed and keep thy flock. I will pass through all thy flock today, removing from thence all the speckled and spotted cattle, and all the brown cattle among the sheep, and the spotted and speckled among the goats, and of such shall be my hire. So shall my righteousness answer for me in time to come, when it shall come for my hire before thy face. Everyone that is not speckled and spotted among the goats and brown among the sheep, that shall be counted stolen with me.
And Laban said,
Behold, I would it might be according to thy word.
And he removed that day the he-goats that were ring-streaked and spotted, and all the she-goats that were speckled and spotted, and every one that had some white in it, and all the brown among the sheep, and gave them into the hand of his sons. And he set 3 days' journey betwixt himself and Jacob. And Jacob fed the rest of Laban's flocks. And Jacob took him rods of green poplar, and of the hazel and chestnut tree, and pilled white streaks in them, and made the white appear which was in the rods. And he set the rods which he had pilled before the flocks in the gutters in the watering troughs, when the flocks came to drink, that they should conceive when they came to drink. And the flocks conceived before the rods, and brought forth cattle ring-streaked, speckled, and spotted. And Jacob did separate the lambs, and set the faces of the flocks toward the ring-streaked, and all the brown in the flock of Laban. And he put his own flocks by themselves, and put them not unto Laban's cattle. And it came to pass, whensoever the stronger cattle did conceive, that Jacob laid the rods before the eyes of the cattle in the gutters, that they might conceive among the rods. But when the cattle were feeble, he put them not in. So the feebler were Laban's, and the stronger Jacob's. And the man increased exceedingly, and had much cattle, and maidservants, and menservants, and camels, and asses. Chapter 31. And he heard the words of Laban's sons, saying,
Jacob hath taken away all that was our father's, and of that which was our father's hath he gotten all this glory.
And Jacob beheld the countenance of Laban, and behold, it was not toward him as before. And the Lord said unto Jacob,
Return unto the land of thy fathers, and to thy kindred, and I will be with thee.
And Jacob sent and called Rachel and Leah to the field unto his flock, and said unto them,
I see your father's countenance, that it is not toward me as before. But the God of my father hath been with me. And ye know that with all my power I have served your father. And your father hath deceived me, and changed my wages 10 times. But God suffered him not to hurt me. If he said thus, The speckled shall be thy wages, then all the cattle bear speckled. And if he said thus, The ring-streaked shall be thy hire, then bear all the cattle ring-streaked. Thus God hath taken away the cattle of your father, and given them to me. And it came to pass at the time that the cattle conceived, that I lifted up mine eyes, and saw in a dream, and behold, the rams which leaped upon the cattle were ring-streaked, speckled, and grizzled. And the angel of God spake unto me in a dream, saying, Jacob. And I said, Here am I. And he said, Lift up now thine eyes, and see, all the rams which leap upon the cattle are ring-streaked, speckled, and grizzled. For I have seen all that Laban doeth unto thee. I am the God of Bethel, where thou anointedst the pillar, and where thou vowedst a vow unto me. Now arise, get thee out from this land, and return unto the land of thy kindred.
And Rachel and Leah answered and said unto him,
Is there yet any portion or inheritance for us in our father's house? Are we not counted of him strangers? For he hath sold us, and hath quite devoured also our money. For all the riches which God hath taken from our father that is ours and our children's, now then, whatsoever God hath said unto thee, do.
Then Jacob rose up and set his sons and his wives upon camels, and he carried away all his cattle and all his goods which he had gotten, the cattle of his getting which he had gotten in Padan Aram, for to go to Isaac his father in the land of Canaan. And Laban went to shear his sheep, and Rachel had stolen the images that were her father's. And Jacob stole away unawares to Laban the Syrian, in that he told him not that he fled. So he fled with all that he had, and he rose up and passed over the river and set his face toward the Mount Gilead. And it was told Laban on the third day that Jacob was fled. And he took his brethren with him and pursued after him 7 days' journey, and they overtook him in the Mount Gilead. And God came to Laban the Syrian in a dream by night and said unto him,
Take heed that thou speak not to Jacob either good or bad.
Then Laban overtook Jacob. Now Jacob had pitched his tent in the mount, and Laban with his brethren pitched in the Mount of Gilead. And Laban said to Jacob,
What hast thou done that thou hast stolen away unawares to me, and carried away my daughters as captives taken with the sword? Wherefore didst thou flee away secretly and steal away from me, and didst not tell me, that I might have sent thee away with mirth and with songs, with tabret and with harp? And hast not suffered me to kiss my sons and my daughters? Thou hast now done foolishly in so doing. It is in the power of my hand to do you hurt. But the God of your father spake unto me yesternight, saying, Take thou heed that thou speak not to Jacob either good or bad. And now, though thou wouldest needs be gone, because thou sore longest after thy father's house, yet wherefore hast thou stolen my gods?
And Jacob answered and said to Laban,
Because I was afraid. For I said, Peradventure, thou wouldest take by force thy daughters from me. With whomsoever thou findest thy gods, let him not live. Before our brethren discern thou what is thine with me, and take it to thee.
For Jacob knew not that Rachel had stolen them. And Laban went into Jacob's tent, and into Leah's tent, and into the two maidservants' tents, but he found them not. Then went he out of Leah's tent, and entered into Rachel's tent. Now Rachel had taken the images, and put them in the camel's furniture, and sat upon them. And Laban searched all the tent, but found them not. And she said to her father,
Let it not displease my lord that I cannot rise up before thee, for the custom of women is upon me.
And he searched, but found not the images. And Jacob was wroth, and chode with Laban. And Jacob answered and said to Laban,
What is my trespass? What is my sin, that thou hast so hotly pursued after me? Whereas thou hast searched all my stuff, what hast thou found of all thy household stuff? Set it here, before my brethren and thy brethren, that they may judge betwixt us both. This 20 years have I been with thee. Thy ewes and thy she-goats have not cast their young, and the rams of thy flock have I not eaten. That which was torn of beasts, I brought not unto thee. I bear the loss of it. Of my hand didst thou require it, whether stolen by day or stolen by night? Thus I was. In the day the drought consumed me, and the frost by night, and my sleep departed from mine eyes. Thus have I been 20 years in thy house. I served thee 14 years for thy two daughters, and 6 years for thy cattle. And thou hast changed my wages 10 times. Except the God of my father, the God of Abraham, and the fear of Isaac had been with me, surely thou hadst sent me away now empty. God hath seen mine affliction and the labor of my hands, and rebuked thee yesternight.
And Laban answered and said unto Jacob,
These daughters are my daughters, and these children are my children, and these cattle are my cattle, and all that thou seest is mine. And what can I do this day unto these my daughters, or unto their children which they have borne? Now therefore come thou, let us make a covenant, I and thou, and let it be for a witness between me and thee.
And Jacob took a stone and set it up for a pillar. And Jacob said unto his brethren,
Gather stones.
And they took stones and made an heap, and they did eat there upon the heap. And Laban called it Jegar-Sahadutha, but Jacob called it Galead. And Laban said,
This heap is a witness between me and thee this day.
Therefore was the name of it called Galead, and Mizpah, for he said,
The Lord watch between me and thee when we are absent one from another. If thou shalt afflict my daughters, or if thou shalt take other wives beside my daughters, no man is with us. See, God is witness betwixt me and thee.
And Laban said to Jacob,
Behold this heap, and behold this pillar, which I have cast betwixt me and thee. This heap be witness, and this pillar be witness, that I will not pass over this heap to thee, and that thou shalt not pass over this heap and this pillar unto me for harm. The God of Abraham
and the God of Nahor, the God of their father, judge betwixt us.
And Jacob sware by the fear of his father Isaac. Then Jacob offered sacrifice upon the mount and called his brethren to eat bread. And they did eat bread and tarried all night in the mount. And early in the morning, Laban rose up and kissed his sons and his daughters and blessed them. And Laban departed and returned unto his place. Chapter 32. And Jacob went on his way, and the angels of God met him. And when Jacob saw them, he said,
"This is God's host."
And he called the name of that place Mahanaim. And Jacob sent messengers before him to Esau his brother, unto the land of Seir, the country of Edom. And he commanded them, saying,
"Thus shall ye speak unto my lord Esau. Thy servant Jacob saith thus, I have sojourned with Laban, and stayed there until now. And I have oxen and asses, flocks and men servants and women servants. And I have sent to tell my lord, that I may find grace in thy sight."
And the messengers returned to Jacob, saying,
"We came to thy brother Esau, and also he cometh to meet thee, and 400 men with him."
Then Jacob was greatly afraid and distressed, and he divided the people that was with him, and the flocks and herds and the camels into two bands, and said,
"If Esau come to the one company and smite it, then the other company which is left shall escape."
And Jacob said,
"O God of my father Abraham, and God of my father Isaac, the Lord which saidst unto me, Return unto thy country and to thy kindred, and I will deal well with thee. I am not worthy of the least of all the mercies, and of all the truth which thou hast showed unto thy servant. For with my staff I passed over this Jordan, and now I am become two bands. Deliver me, I pray thee, from the hand of my brother, from the hand of Esau. For I fear him, lest he will come and smite me, and the mother with the children. And thou saidst, I will surely do thee good, and make thy seed as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered for multitude."
And he lodged there that same night, and took of that which came to his hand a present for Esau his brother, 200 she-goats and 20 he-goats, 200 ewes and 20 rams, 30 milch camels with their colts, 40 kine and 10 bulls, 20 she-asses and 10 foals. And he delivered them into the hand of his servants, every drove by themselves, and said unto his servants,
"Pass over before me, and put a space betwixt drove and drove."
And he commanded the foremost, saying,
"When Esau my brother meeteth thee, and asketh thee, saying, Whose art thou, and whither goest thou, and whose are these before thee? Then thou shalt say, They be thy servant Jacob's. It is a present sent unto my lord Esau, and behold, also he is behind us."
And so commanded he the second, and the third, and all that followed the drove, saying,
"On this manner shall ye speak unto Esau when ye find him. And say ye moreover, Behold, thy servant Jacob is behind us."
For he said,
"I will appease him with the present that goeth before me, and afterward I will see his face. Peradventure he will accept of me."
So went the present over before him, and himself lodged that night in the company. And he rose up that night, and took his two wives, and his two women servants, and his 11 sons, and passed over the ford Jabbok. And he took them, and set them over the brook, and sent over that he had. And Jacob was left alone. And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said,
"Let me go, for the day breaketh."
And he said,
"I will not let thee go, except thou bless me."
And he said unto him,
"What is thy name?"
And he said,
"Jacob."
And he said,
"Thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince hast thou power with God and with men, and hast prevailed."
And Jacob asked him and said,
"Tell me, I pray thee, thy name."
And he said,
"Wherefore is it that thou dost ask after my name?"
And he blessed him there. And Jacob called the name of the place Peniel.
"For I have seen God face to face, and my life is preserved."
And as he passed over Peniel, the sun rose upon him, and he halted upon his thigh. Therefore the children of Israel eat not of the sinew which shrank, which is upon the hollow of the thigh unto this day, because he touched the hollow of Jacob's thigh in the sinew that shrank. Chapter 33. And Jacob lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, Esau came, and with him 400 men, And he divided the children unto Leah, and unto Rachel, and unto the two handmaids. And he put the handmaids and their children foremost, and Leah and her children after, and Rachel and Joseph hindermost. And he passed over before them, and bowed himself to the ground 7 times, until he came near to his brother. And Esau ran to meet him, and embraced him, and fell on his neck, and kissed him, and they wept. And he lifted up his eyes, and saw the women, and the children, and said,
Who are those with thee?
And he said,
The children, which God hath graciously given thy servant.
Then the handmaidens came near, they and their children, and they bowed themselves. And Leah also with her children came near, and bowed themselves. And after came Joseph near, and Rachel, and they bowed themselves. And he said,
What meanest thou by all this drove which I met?
And he said,
These are to find grace in the sight of my Lord.
And Esau said,
I have enough, my brother. Keep that thou hast unto thyself.
And Jacob said,
Nay, I pray thee, if now I have found grace in thy sight, then receive my present at my hand. For therefore I have seen thy face, as though I had seen the face of God, and thou wast pleased with me. Take, I pray thee, my blessing that is brought to thee, because God hath dealt graciously with me, and because I have enough.
And he urged him, and he took it, and he said,
Let us take our journey, and let us go, and I will go before thee.
And he said unto him,
My Lord knoweth that the children are tender, and the flocks and herds with young are with me. And if men should overdrive them one day, all the flock will die. Let, my Lord, I pray thee, pass over before his servant, and I will lead on softly, according as the cattle that goeth before me, and the children be able to endure, until I come unto my Lord, unto Seir.
And Esau said,
Let me now leave with thee some of the folk that are with me.
And he said,
What needeth it? Let me find grace in the sight of my Lord.
So Esau returned that day on his way to Seir. And Jacob journeyed to Succoth, and built him an house, and made booths for his cattle. Therefore the name of the place is called Succoth. And Jacob came to Shalem, a city of Shechem, which is in the land of Canaan, when he came from Padan Aram, and pitched his tent before the city. And he brought a parcel of a field where he had spread his tent at the hand of the children of Hamor, Shechem's father, for 100 pieces of money. And he erected there an altar, and called it El Elohe Israel. Chapter 34. And Dinah, the daughter of Leah, which she bare unto Jacob, went out to see the daughters of the land. And when Shechem, the son of Hamor the Hivite, prince of the country, saw her, he took her and lay with her and defiled her. And his soul clave unto Dinah, the daughter of Jacob, and he loved the damsel, and spake kindly unto the damsel. And Shechem spake unto his father Hamor, saying,
Get me this damsel to wife.
And Jacob heard that he had defiled Dinah his daughter. Now his sons were with his cattle in the field, and Jacob held his peace until they were come. And Hamor, the father of Shechem, went out unto Jacob to commune with him. And the sons of Jacob came out of the field when they heard it, and the men were grieved, and they were very wroth, because he had wrought folly in Israel in lying with Jacob's daughter, which thing ought not to be done. And Hamor communed with them, saying,
The soul of my son Shechem longeth for your daughter. I pray you give her him to wife, and make ye marriages with us, and give your daughters unto us, and take our daughters unto you. And ye shall dwell with us, and the land shall be before you. Dwell and trade ye therein, and get you possessions therein.
And Shechem said unto her father and unto her brethren,
Let me find grace in your eyes, and what ye shall say unto me I will give. Ask me never so much dowry and gift, and I will give according as ye shall say unto me. But give me the damsel to wife.
And the sons of Jacob answered Shechem and Hamor his father deceitfully, and said, Because he had defiled Dinah their sister. And they said unto them,
We cannot do this thing, to give our sister to one that is uncircumcised, for that were a reproach unto us. But in this will we consent unto you. If ye will be as we be, that every male of you be circumcised, then will we give our daughters unto you, and we will take your daughters to us, and we will dwell with you, and we will become one people. But if ye will not hearken unto us to be circumcised, then will we take our daughter, and we will be gone.
And their words pleased Hamor and Shechem, Hamor's son. And the young man deferred not to do the thing, because he had delight in Jacob's daughter, and he was more honorable than all the house of his father. And Hamor and Shechem his son came unto the gate of their city, and communed with the men of their city, saying,
These men are peaceable with us. Therefore let them dwell in the land, and trade therein. For the land, behold, it is large enough for them. Let us take their daughters to us for wives, and let us give them our daughters. Only herein will the men consent unto us for to dwell with us, to be one people, if every male among us be circumcised as they are circumcised. Shall not their cattle and their substance and every beast of theirs be ours? Only let us consent unto them, and they will dwell with us.
And unto Hamor and unto Shechem his son hearkened all that went out of the gate of his city, and every male was circumcised, all that went out of the gate of his city. And it came to pass on the third day, when they were sore, that two of the sons of Jacob, Simeon and Levi, Dinah's brethren, took each man his sword, and came upon the city boldly, and slew all the males. And they slew Hamor and Shechem his son with the edge of the sword, and took Dinah out of Shechem's house, and went out. The sons of Jacob came upon the slain, and spoiled the city, because they had defiled their sister. They took their sheep, and their oxen, and their asses, and that which was in the city, and that which was in the field, and all their wealth, and all their little ones, and their wives took they captive, and spoiled even all that was in the house. And Jacob said to Simeon and Levi,
Ye have troubled me, to make me to stink among the inhabitants of the land, among the Canaanites and the Perizzites. And I, being few in number, they shall gather themselves together against me and slay me. And I shall be destroyed, I and my house.
And they said,
Should he deal with our sister as with an harlot?
Chapter 35. And God said unto Jacob,
Arise, go up to Bethel, and dwell there, and make there an altar unto God that appeared unto thee when thou fleddest from the face of Esau thy brother.
Then Jacob said unto his household and to all that were with him,
Put away the strange gods that are among you, and be clean, and change your garments. And let us arise, and go up to Bethel. And I will make there an altar unto God, who answered me in the day of my distress, and was with me in the way which I went.
And they gave unto Jacob all the strange gods which were in their hand, and all their earrings which were in their ears. And Jacob hid them under the oak which was by Shechem. And they journeyed, and the terror of God was upon the cities that were round about them, and they did not pursue after the sons of Jacob. So Jacob came to Luz, which is in the land of Canaan, that is Bethel, he and all the people that were with him. And he built there an altar, and called the place El Bethel, because there God appeared unto him when he fled from the face of his brother. But Deborah, Rebekah's nurse, died, and she was buried beneath Bethel under an oak. And the name of it was called Allenbacheth. And God appeared unto Jacob again when he came out of Padan Aram, and blessed him. And God said unto him,
Thy name is Jacob. Thy name shall not be called any more Jacob, but Israel shall be thy name.
And he called his name Israel. And God said unto him,
I am God Almighty. Be fruitful and multiply. A nation and a company of nations shall be of thee, and kings shall come out of thy loins. And the land which I gave Abraham and Isaac, to thee I will give it, and to thy seed after thee will I give the land.
And God went up from him in the place where he talked with him. And Jacob set up a pillar in the place where he talked with him, even a pillar of stone. And he poured a drink offering thereon, and he poured oil thereon. And Jacob called the name of the place where God spake with him, Bethel. And they journeyed from Bethel, and there was but a little way to come to Ephrath. And Rachel travailed, and she had hard labor. And it came to pass, when she was in hard labor, that the midwife said unto her,
Fear not, thou shalt have this son also.
And it came to pass, as her soul was in departing, for she died, that she called his name Ben-Oni, but his father called him Benjamin. And Rachel died, and was buried in the way to Ephrath, which is Bethlehem. And Jacob set a pillar upon her grave, that is the pillar of Rachel's grave, unto this day. And Israel journeyed, and spread his tent beyond the tower of Eder. And it came to pass, when Israel dwelt in that land, that Reuben went and lay with Bilhah, his father's concubine, and Israel heard it. Now the sons of Jacob were 12. The sons of Leah, Reuben, Jacob's firstborn, and Simeon, and Levi, and Judah, and Issachar, and Zebulun. The sons of Rachel, Joseph, and Benjamin. And the sons of Bilhah, Rachel's handmaid, Dan and Naphtali. And the sons of Zilpah, Leah's handmaid, Gad and Asher. These are the sons of Jacob, which were born to him in Padan Aram. And Jacob came unto Isaac his father, unto Mamre, unto the city of Arba, which is Hebron, where Abraham and Isaac sojourned. And the days of Isaac were 180 years. And Isaac gave up the ghost and died, and was gathered unto his people, being old and full of days. And his sons Esau and Jacob buried him. Chapter 36. Now these are the generations of Esau, who is Edom. Esau took his wives of the daughters of Canaan, Adah, the daughter of Elon the Hittite, and Aholibamah, the daughter of Anah, the daughter of Zibeon the Hivite, and Bashemath, Ishmael's daughter, sister of Nebajoth. And Adah bare to Esau Eliphaz, and Bashemath bare Reuel, and Aholibamah bare Jeush, and Jaalam, and Korah. These are the sons of Esau, which were born unto him in the land of Canaan. And Esau took his wives, and his sons, and his daughters, and all the persons of his house, and his cattle, and all his beasts, and all his substance, which he had got in the land of Canaan, and went into the country from the face of his brother Jacob. For their riches were more than that they might dwell together, and the land wherein they were strangers could not bear them, because of their cattle. Thus dwelt Esau in Mount Seir. Esau is Edom. And these are the generations of Esau, the father of the Edomites in Mount Seir. These are the names of Esau's sons: Eliphaz, the son of Adah, the wife of Esau; Reuel, the son of Bashemath, the wife of Esau. And the sons of Eliphaz were Teman, Omar, Zepho, and Gatim, and Kenaz. And Timnah was concubine to Eliphaz, Esau's son. And she bare to Eliphaz Amalek. These were the sons of Adah, Esau's wife. And these are the sons of Reuel: Nahath, and Zerah, Shammah, and Mizah. These were the sons of Bashemath, Esau's wife. And these were the sons of Aholibamah, the daughter of Anah, the daughter of Zibeon, Esau's wife. And she bare to Esau Jeush, and Jaalam, and Korah. These were dukes of the sons of Esau, the sons of Eliphaz, the firstborn son of Esau: Duke Teman, Duke Omar, Duke Zepho, Duke Kenaz, Duke Korah, Duke Gatim, and Duke Amalek. These are the dukes that came of Eliphaz in the land of Edom. These were the sons of Adah. And these are the sons of Reuel, Esau's son: Duke Nahath, Duke Zerah, Duke Shammah, Duke Mizah. These are the dukes that came of Reuel in the land of Edom. These are the sons of Bashemath, Esau's wife. And these are the sons of Aholibamah, Esau's wife: Duke Jeush, Duke Jaalam, Duke Korah. These were the dukes that came of Aholibamah, the daughter of Anah, Esau's wife. These are the sons of Esau, who is Edom, and these are their dukes. These are the sons of Seir the Horite, who inhabited the land: Lotan, and Shobal, and Zibeon, and Anah, and Dishan, and Ezer, and Dishan. These are the dukes of the Horites, the children of Seir in the land of Edom. And the children of Lotan were Horai and Hemam, and Lotan's sister was Timnah. And the children of Shobal were these: Alvan, and Manahath, and Ebal, Shepho, and Onam. And these are the children of Zibeon, both Aja and Anah. This was that Anah that found the mules in the wilderness, as he fed the asses of Zibeon his father. And the children of Anah were these: Dishan, and Aholibamah, the daughter of Anah. And these are the children of Dishan: Hemdan, and Eshban, and Ithran, and Kiran. The children of Ezer are these: Bilhan, and Zaavan, and Achan. The children of Dishan are these: Uz, and Aaron. These are the dukes that came of the Horites: Duke Lotan, Duke Shobal, Duke Zibeon, Duke Anah, Duke Dishan, Duke Anah, Duke Dishan. These are the dukes that came of Horai, among their dukes in the land of Seir. And these are the kings that reigned in the land of Edom before there reigned any king over the children of Israel. And Bela the son of Beor reigned in Edom, and the name of his city was Dinhabah. And Bela died, and Jobab, the son of Zerah of Bozrah, reigned in his stead. And Jobab died, and Husham of the land of Temani reigned in his stead. And Husham died, and Hadad, the son of Bedad, who smote Midian in the field of Moab, reigned in his stead. And the name of his city was Avith. And Hadad died, and Samlah of Masrekah reigned in his stead. And Samlah died, and Saul of Rehoboth by the river reigned in his stead. And Saul died, and Baal-Hanan the son of Achbor reigned in his stead. And Baal-Hanan the son of Achbor died, and Hadar reigned in his stead. And the name of his city was Pu, and his wife's name was Mehetabel, the daughter of Matred, the daughter of Mezahab. And these are the names of the dukes that came of Esau, according to their families, after their places, by their names: Duke Timnah, Duke Alva, Duke Jetheth, Duke Aholibamah, Duke Elah, Duke Pinon, Duke Kenaz, Duke Teman, Duke Mibzar, Duke Magdiel, Duke Iram. These be the dukes of Edom, according to their habitations in the land of their possession. He is Esau, the father of the Edomites. Chapter 37. And Jacob dwelt in the land wherein his father was a stranger, in the land of Canaan. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah, and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought unto his father their evil report. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his old age. And he made him a coat of many colors. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him, and could not speak peaceably unto him. And Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told it his brethren, and they hated him yet the more. And he said unto them,
Hear, I pray you, this dream which I have dreamed. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose, and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaves stood round about, and made obeisance to my sheaf.
And his brethren said unto him,
Shalt thou indeed reign over us, or shalt thou indeed have dominion over us?
And they hated him yet the more for his dreams and for his words. And he dreamed yet another dream, and told it his brethren, and said,
Behold, I have dreamed a dream more, and behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me.
And he told it to his father, and to his brethren, and his father rebuked him, and said unto him,
What is this dream that thou hast dreamed? Shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee, to the earth?
And his brethren envied him, but his father observed the saying. And his brethren went to feed their father's flock in Shechem. And Israel said unto Joseph,
Do not thy brethren feed the flock in Shechem? Come, and I will send thee unto them.
And he said to him,
Here am I.
And he said to him,
Go, I pray thee, see whether it be well with thy brethren, and well with the flocks, and bring me word again.
So he sent him out of the vale of Hebron, and he came to Shechem. And a certain man found him, and behold, he was wandering in the field. And the man asked him, saying,
What seekest thou?
And he said,
I seek my brethren. Tell me, I pray thee, where they feed their flocks.
And the man said,
They are departed hence, for I heard them say, Let us go to Dothan.
And Joseph went after his brethren and found them in Dothan. And when they saw him afar off, even before he came near unto them, they conspired against him to slay him. And they said one to another,
Behold, this dreamer cometh. Come now, therefore, and let us slay him and cast him into some pit. And we will say, Some evil beast hath devoured him, and we shall see what will become of his dreams.
And Reuben heard it, and he delivered him out of their hands, and said, Let us not kill him. And Reuben said unto them,
Shed no blood, but cast him into this pit that is in the wilderness, and lay no hand upon him.
That he might rid him out of their hands to deliver him to his father again. And it came to pass, when Joseph was come unto his brethren, that they stripped Joseph out of his coat of many colors that was on him. And they took him and cast him into a pit, and the pit was empty, there was no water in it. And they sat down to eat bread, and they lifted up their eyes and looked, and behold, a company of Ishmaelites came from Gilead with their camels, bearing spicery and balm and myrrh, going to carry it down to Egypt. And Judah said unto his brethren,
What profit is it if we slay our brother and conceal his blood? Come, and let us sell him to the Ishmaelites, and let not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother and our flesh.
And his brethren were content. Then there passed by Midianites, merchantmen, and they drew and lifted up Joseph out of the pit, and sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites for 20 pieces of silver, and they brought Joseph into Egypt. And Reuben returned unto the pit, and behold, Joseph was not in the pit, and he rent his clothes, and he returned unto his brethren and said,
The child is not, and I, whither shall I go?
And they took Joseph's coat and killed a kid of the goats, and dipped the coat in the blood. And they sent the coat of many colors, and they brought it to their father and said,
This have we found. Know now whether it be thy son's coat or no.
And he knew it and said,
It is my son's coat. An evil beast hath devoured him. Joseph is without doubt rent in pieces.
And Jacob rent his clothes and put sackcloth upon his loins and mourned for his son many days. And all his sons and all his daughters rose up to comfort him, but he refused to be comforted. And he said,
For I will go down into the grave unto my son, mourning.
Thus his father wept for him. And the Midianites sold him into Egypt unto Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh's and captain of the guard. Chapter 38. And it came to pass at that time that Judah went down from his brethren and turned into a certain Adullamite whose name was Hira. And Judah saw there a daughter of a certain Canaanite whose name was Shua. And he took her, and went in unto her. And she conceived, and bare a son. And he called his name Ur. And she conceived again, and bare a son, and she called his name Onan. And she yet again conceived and bare a son, and called his name Shelah, and he was at Kezeb when she bare him. And Judah took a wife for his firstborn, whose name was Tamar. And Judah's firstborn, was wicked in the sight of the Lord. And the Lord slew him. And Judah said unto Onan,
Go in unto thy brother's wife, and marry her, and raise up seed to thy brother.
And Onan knew that the seed should not be his. And it came to pass, when he went in unto his brother's wife, that he spilled it on the ground, lest that he should give seed to his brother. And the thing which he did displeased the Lord, wherefore he slew him also. Then said Judah to Tamar his daughter-in-law,
Remain a widow at thy father's house, till Shelah my son be grown.
For he said,
Lest peradventure he die also, as his brethren did.
And Tamar went and dwelt in her father's house. And in process of time the daughter of Shua, Judah's wife, died. And Judah was comforted, and went up unto his sheep shearers to Timnath, he and his friend Hira the Adullamite. And it was told Tamar, saying, Behold, thy father-in-law goeth up to Timnath to shear his sheep. And she put her widow's garments off from her, and covered her with a veil, and wrapped herself, and sat in an open place which is by the way to Timnath. For she saw that Shelah was grown, and she was not given unto him to wife. When Judah saw her, he thought her to be an harlot, because she had covered her face. And he turned unto her by the way, and said,
Go to, I pray thee, let me come in unto thee.
For he knew not that she was his daughter-in-law. And she said,
What wilt thou give me, that thou mayest come in unto me?
And he said,
I will send thee a kid from the flock.
And she said,
Wilt thou give me a pledge till thou send it?
And he said,
What pledge shall I give thee?
And she said,
Thy signet, and thy bracelets, and thy staff that is in thine hand.
And he gave it her, and came in unto her, and she conceived by him. And she arose and went away, and laid by her veil from her, and put on the garments of her widowhood. And Judah sent the kid by the hand of his friend the Adullamite, to receive his pledge from the woman's hand. But he found her not. Then he asked the men of that place, saying,
Where is the harlot that was openly by the wayside?
And they said,
There was no harlot in this place.
And he returned to Judah and said,
I cannot find her. And also the men of the place said that there was no harlot in this place.
And Judah said,
Let her take it to her, lest we be shamed. Behold, I sent this kid, and thou hast not found her.
And it came to pass about 3 months after, that it was told Judah, saying, Tamar thy daughter-in-law hath played the harlot, and also, behold, she is with child by whoredom. And Judah said,
Bring her forth, and let her be burnt.
When she was brought forth, she sent to her father-in-law, saying,
By the man whose these are am I with child.
And she said,
Discern, I pray thee, whose are these, the signet and bracelets and staff?
And Judah acknowledged them and said,
She hath been more righteous than I, because that I gave her not to Shelah my son.
And he knew her again no more. And it came to pass in the time of her travail that, behold, twins were in her womb. And it came to pass when she travailed that the one put out his hand, and the midwife took and bound upon his hand a scarlet thread, saying,
This came out first.
And it came to pass as he drew back his hand that, behold, his brother came out, and she said,
How hast thou broken forth? This breach be upon thee.
Therefore his name was called Phares. And afterward came out his brother that had the scarlet thread upon his hand, and his name was called Zerah. Chapter 39. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, bought him of the hands of the Ishmaelites, which had brought him down thither. And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. And Joseph found grace in his sight, and he served him. And he made him overseer over his house, and all that he had he put into his hand. And it came to pass from the time that he had made him overseer in his house, and over all that he had, that the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. And the blessing of the Lord was upon all that he had in the house and in the field. And he left all that he had in Joseph's hand, and he knew not aught he had, save the bread which he did eat. And Joseph was a goodly person, and well favored. And it came to pass after these things, that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph, and she said,
Lie with me.
But he refused, and said unto his master's wife,
Behold, my master wotteth not what is with me in the house, and he hath committed all that he hath to my hand. There is none greater in this house than I. Neither hath he kept back anything from me but thee, because thou art his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God?
And it came to pass, as she spake to Joseph day by day, that he hearkened not unto her to lie by her, or to be with her. And it came to pass about this time that Joseph went into the house to do his business, and there was none of the men of the house there within. And she caught him by his garment, saying,
Lie with me.
And he left his garment in her hand and fled and got him out. And it came to pass, when she saw that he had left his garment in her hand and was fled forth, that she called unto the men of her house and spake unto them, saying,
See, he hath brought in an Hebrew unto us to mock us. He came in unto me to lie with me, and I cried with a loud voice. And it came to pass, when he heard that I lifted up my voice and cried, that he left his garment with me, and fled, and got him out.
And she laid up his garment by her until his lord came home. And she spake unto him according to these words, saying,
The Hebrew servant which thou hast brought unto us came in unto me to mock me. And it came to pass, as I lifted up my voice and cried, that he left his garment with me and fled out.
And it came to pass, when his master heard the words of his wife, which she spake unto him, saying,
After this manner did thy servant to me,
that his wrath was kindled. And Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison, a place where the king's prisoners were bound, and he was there in the prison. But the Lord was with Joseph, and showed him mercy, and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners that were in the prison, and whatsoever they did there, he was the doer of it. The keeper of the prison looked not to anything that was under his hand, because the Lord was with him, and that which he did, the Lord made it to prosper. Chapter 40. And it came to pass after these things, that the butler of the king of Egypt and his baker had offended their lord the king of Egypt. And Pharaoh was wroth against two of his officers, against the chief of the butlers and against the chief of the bakers. And he put them in ward in the house of the captain of the guard into the prison, the place where Joseph was bound. And the captain of the guard charged Joseph with them, and he served them. And they continued a season in ward. And they dreamed a dream, both of them, each man his dream in one night, each man according to the interpretation of his dream, the butler and the baker of the king of Egypt, which were bound in the prison. And Joseph came in unto them in the morning, and looked upon them, and behold, they were sad. And he asked Pharaoh's officers that were with him in the ward of his lord's house, saying,
Wherefore look ye so sadly today?
And they said unto him,
We have dreamed a dream, and there is no interpreter of it.
And Joseph said unto them,
Do not interpretations belong to God? Tell me them, I pray you.
And the chief butler told his dream to Joseph, and said to him,
In my dream, behold, a vine was before me, and in the vine were three branches, and it was as though it budded, and her blossoms shot forth, and the clusters thereof brought forth ripe grapes. And Pharaoh's cup was in my hand, and I took the grapes and pressed them into Pharaoh's cup, and I gave the cup into Pharaoh's hand.
And Joseph said unto him,
This is the interpretation of it. The three branches are 3 days. Yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thine head and restore thee unto thy place. And thou shalt deliver Pharaoh's cup into his hand after the former manner when thou wast his butler. But think on me when it shall be well with thee, and show kindness, I pray thee, unto me, and make mention of me unto Pharaoh, and bring me out of this house. For indeed I was stolen away out of the land of the Hebrews. And here also have I done nothing that they should put me into the dungeon.
When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was good, he said unto Joseph,
I also was in my dream, and behold, I had 3 white baskets on my head. And in the uppermost basket there was of all manner of baked meats for Pharaoh. And the birds did eat them out of the basket upon my head.
And Joseph answered and said,
This is the interpretation thereof. The 3 baskets are 3 days, yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thy head from off thee, and shall hang thee on a tree, and the bird shall eat thy flesh from off thee.
And it came to pass the 3rd day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, that he made a feast unto all his servants. And he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. And he restored the chief butler unto his butlership again, and he gave the cup into Pharaoh's hand. But he hanged the chief baker, as Joseph had interpreted to them. Yet did not the chief butler remember Joseph, but forgot him. Chapter 41. And it came to pass at the end of 2 full years that Pharaoh dreamed, and behold, he stood by the river. And behold, there came up out of the river 7 well-favored kine and fat-fleshed, and they fed in a meadow. And behold, 7 other kine came up after them out of the river, ill-favored and lean-fleshed, and stood by the other kine upon the brink of the river. And the ill-favored and lean-fleshed kine did eat up the 7 well-favored and fat kine. So Pharaoh awoke, and he slept and dreamed the second time. And behold, 7 ears of corn came up upon one stalk, rank and good. And behold, 7 thin ears, and blasted with the east wind, sprung up after them. And the 7 thin ears devoured the 7 rank and full ears. And Pharaoh awoke, and behold, it was a dream. And it came to pass in the morning that his spirit was troubled, and he sent and called for all the magicians of Egypt, and all the wise men thereof. And Pharaoh told them his dream, but there was none that could interpret them unto Pharaoh. Then spake the chief butler unto Pharaoh, saying,
I do remember my faults this day. Pharaoh was wroth with his servants, and put me in ward in the captain of the guard's house, both me and the chief baker. And we dreamed a dream in one night, I and he. We dreamed each man according to the interpretation of his dream. And there was there with us a young man, an Hebrew, servant to the captain of the guard. And we told him, and he interpreted to us our dreams. To each man according to his dream he did interpret. And it came to pass, as he interpreted to us, so it was. Me he restored unto mine office, and him he hanged.
Then Pharaoh sent and called Joseph, and they brought him hastily out of the dungeon. And he shaved himself, and changed his raiment, and came in unto Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph,
I have dreamed a dream, and there is none that can interpret it. And I have heard say of thee that thou canst understand a dream to interpret it.
And Joseph answered Pharaoh, saying,
It is not in me. God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace.
And Pharaoh said unto Joseph,
In my dream, behold, I stood upon the bank of the river. And behold, there came up out of the river 7 kine, fat-fleshed and well-favored, and they fed in a meadow. And behold, 7 other kine came up after them, poor and very ill-favored and lean-fleshed, such as I never saw in all the land of Egypt for badness. And the lean and the ill-favored kine did eat up the first 7 fat kine. And when they had eaten them up, it could not be known that they had eaten them, but they were still ill-favored as at the beginning. So I awoke, and I saw in my dream, and behold, 7 ears came up in one stalk, full and good. And behold, 7 ears, withered, thin, and blasted with the east wind, sprung up after them. And the thin ears devoured the 7 good ears, and I told this unto the magicians, but there was none that could declare it to me.
And Joseph said unto Pharaoh,
The dream of Pharaoh is one. God hath showed Pharaoh what he is about to do. The 7 good kine are 7 years, and the 7 good ears are 7 years. The dream is one. And the 7 thin and ill-favored kine that came up after them are 7 years, and the 7 empty ears blasted with the east wind shall be 7 years of famine. This is the thing which I have spoken unto Pharaoh. What God is about to do, he showeth unto Pharaoh. Behold, there come 7 years of great plenty throughout all the land of Egypt. And there shall arise after them 7 years of famine, and all the plenty shall be forgotten in the land of Egypt, and the famine shall consume the land, and the plenty shall not be known in the land by reason of that famine following, for it shall be very grievous. And for that the dream was doubled unto Pharaoh twice. It is because the thing is established by God, and God will shortly bring it to pass. Now, therefore, let Pharaoh look out a man discreet and wise, and set him over the land of Egypt. Let Pharaoh do this, and let him appoint officers over the land, and take up the 5th part of the land of Egypt in the 7 plenteous years. And let them gather all the food of those good years that come, and lay up corn under the hand of Pharaoh. And let them keep food in the cities. And that food shall be for store to the land against the 7 years of famine, which shall be in the land of Egypt, that the land perish not through the famine.
And the thing was good in the eyes of Pharaoh, and in the eyes of all his servants. And Pharaoh said unto his servants,
Can we find such a one as this is, a man in whom the Spirit of God is?
And Pharaoh said unto Joseph,
For as much as God hath showed thee all this, there is none so discreet and wise as thou art. Thou shalt be over my house, and according unto thy word shall all my people be ruled. Only in the throne will I be greater than thou.
And Pharaoh said unto Joseph,
See, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt.
And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand, and put it upon Joseph's hand, and arrayed him in vestures of fine linen, and put a gold chain about his neck. And he made him to ride in the 2nd chariot which he had. And they cried before him,
Bow the knee.
And he made him ruler over all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph,
I am Pharaoh, and without thee shall no man lift up his hand or foot in all the land of Egypt.
And Pharaoh called Joseph's name Zaphnath-Paneah, and he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On. And Joseph went out over all the land of Egypt. And Joseph was 30 years old when he stood before Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And Joseph went out from the presence of Pharaoh, and went throughout all the land of Egypt. And in the 7 plenteous years the earth brought forth by handfuls, and he gathered up all the food of the 7 years which were in the land of Egypt, and laid up the food in the cities. The food of the field which was round about every city laid he up in the same. And Joseph gathered corn as the sand of the sea, very much, until he left numbering, for it was without number. And unto Joseph were born 2 sons before the years of famine came, which Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On, bare unto him. And Joseph called the name of the firstborn Manasseh.
For God,
said he,
hath made me forget all my toil and all my father's house.
And the name of the second called he Ephraim.
For God hath caused me to be fruitful in the land of my affliction.
And the 7 years of plenteousness that was in the land of Egypt were ended. And the 7 years of dearth began to come, according as Joseph had said. And the dearth was in all lands, but in all the land of Egypt there was bread. And when all the land of Egypt was famished, the people cried to Pharaoh for bread. And Pharaoh said unto all the Egyptians,
Go unto Joseph, what he saith to you, do.
And the famine was over all the face of the earth. And Joseph opened all the storehouses, and sold unto the Egyptians. And the famine waxed sore in the land of Egypt. And all countries came into Egypt to Joseph for to buy corn, because that the famine was so sore in all lands. Chapter 42. Now when Jacob saw that there was corn in Egypt, Jacob said unto his sons,
Why do ye look one upon another?
And he said,
Behold, I have heard that there is corn in Egypt. Get you down thither, and buy for us from thence, that we may live and not die.
And Joseph's 10 brethren went down to buy corn in Egypt. But Benjamin, Joseph's brother, Jacob sent not with his brethren, for he said,
Lest peradventure mischief befall him.
And the sons of Israel came to buy corn among those that came, for the famine was in the land of Canaan. And Joseph was the governor over the land, and he it was that sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brethren came and bowed down themselves before him with their faces to the earth. And Joseph saw his brethren, and he knew them, but made himself strange unto them, and spake roughly unto them. And he said unto them,
Whence come ye?
And they said,
From the land of Canaan to buy food.
And Joseph knew his brethren, but they knew not him. And Joseph remembered the dreams which he dreamed of them, and said unto them,
Ye are spies, to see the nakedness of the land ye are come.
And they said unto him,
Nay, my lord, but to buy food are thy servants come. We are all one man's sons. We are true men. Thy servants are no spies.
And he said unto them,
Nay, but to see the nakedness of the land ye are come.
And they said,
Thy servants are 12 brethren, the sons of one man in the land of Canaan. And behold, the youngest is this day with our father, and one is not.
And Joseph said unto them,
That is it that I spake unto you, saying, Ye are spies. Hereby ye shall be proved. By the life of Pharaoh ye shall not go forth hence, except your youngest brother come hither. Send one of you, and let him fetch your brother. And ye shall be kept in prison, that your words may be proved whether there be any truth in you. Or else, by the life of Pharaoh, surely ye are spies.
And he put them all together into ward 3 days. And Joseph said unto them the 3rd day,
This do and live, for I fear God. If ye be true men, let one of your brethren be bound in the house of your prison. Go ye, carry corn for the famine of your houses. But bring your youngest brother unto me. So shall your words be verified, and ye shall not die.
And they did so. And they said one to another,
We are verily guilty concerning our brother, in that we saw the anguish of his soul when he besought us, and we would not hear. Therefore is this distress come upon us.
And Reuben answered them, saying,
Spake I not unto you, saying, Do not sin against the child, and ye would not hear? Therefore, behold, also his blood is required.
And they knew not that Joseph understood them, for he spake unto them by an interpreter. And he turned himself about from them and wept, and returned to them again, and communed with them. and took from them Simeon and bound him before their eyes. Then Joseph commanded to fill their sacks with corn and to restore every man's money into his sack and to give them provision for the way. And thus did he unto them. And they laded their asses with the corn and departed thence. And as one of them opened his sack to give his ass provender in the inn, he espied his money. For behold, it was in his sack's mouth. And he said unto his brethren,
My money is restored, and lo, it is even in my sack.
And their heart failed them, and they were afraid, saying one to another,
What is this that God hath done unto us?
And they came unto Jacob their father, unto the land of Canaan, and told him all that befell unto them, saying,
The man who is the lord of the land spake roughly to us, and took us for spies of the country. And we said unto him, We are true men, we are no spies. We be 12 brethren, sons of our father, one is not. And the youngest is this day with our father in the land of Canaan. And the man, the lord of the country, said unto us, Hereby shall I know that ye are true men. Leave one of your brethren here with me, and take food for the famine of your households, and be gone. And bring your youngest brother unto me. Then shall I know that ye are no spies, but that ye are true men. So will I deliver you your brother, and ye shall traffic in the land.
And it came to pass as they emptied their sacks, that behold, every man's bundle of money was in his sack. And when both they and their father saw the bundles of money, they were afraid. And Jacob their father said unto them,
Me have ye bereaved of my children. Joseph is not, and Simeon is not. And ye will take Benjamin away. All these things are against me.
And Reuben spake unto his father, saying,
Slay my two sons, if I bring him not to thee. Deliver him into my hand, and I will bring him to thee again.
And he said,
My son shall not go down with you, for his brother is dead, and he is left alone. If mischief befall him by the way in the which ye go, then shall ye bring down my gray hairs with sorrow to the grave.
Chapter 43. And the famine was sore in the land. And it came to pass, when they had eaten up the corn which they had brought out of Egypt, their father said unto them,
Go again, buy us a little food.
And Judah spake unto him, saying,
The man did solemnly protest unto us, saying, Ye shall not see my face, except your brother be with you. If thou wilt send our brother with us, we will go down and buy thee food. But if thou wilt not send him, we will not go down. For the man said unto us, Ye shall not see my face, except your brother be with you.
And Israel said,
Wherefore dealt ye so ill with me, as to tell the man whether ye had yet a brother?
And they said,
The man asked us straitly of our state and of our kindred, saying, Is your father yet alive? Have ye another brother? And we told him, according to the tenor of these words, could we certainly know that he would say, Bring your brother down?
And Judah said unto Israel his father,
Send the lad with me, and we will arise and go, that we may live and not die, both we and thou, and also our little ones. I will be surety for him. Of my hand shalt thou require him. If I bring him not unto thee, and set him before thee, then let me bear the blame forever. For except we had lingered, surely now we had returned this second time.
And their father Israel said unto them,
If it must be so now, do this. Take of the best fruits in the land in your vessels, and carry down the man a present, a little balm, and a little honey, spices, and myrrh, nuts, and almonds. And take double money in your hand, and the money that was brought again in the mouth of your sacks, carry it again in your hand. Peradventure it was an oversight. Take also your brother, and arise, go again unto the man. And God Almighty give you mercy before the man, that he may send away your other brother and Benjamin. If I be bereaved of my children, I am bereaved.
And the men took that present, and they took double money in their hand, and Benjamin, and rose up and went down to Egypt, and stood before Joseph. And when Joseph saw Benjamin with them, he said to the ruler of his house,
"Bring these men home, and slay, and make ready, for these men shall dine with me at noon."
And the man did as Joseph bade, and the man brought the men into Joseph's house. And the men were afraid, because they were brought into Joseph's house, and they said,
"Because of the money that was returned in our sacks at the first time are we brought in, that he may seek occasion against us, and fall upon us, and take us for bondmen, and our asses."
And they came near to the steward of Joseph's house, and they communed with him at the door of the house, and said,
"Oh, sir, we came indeed down at the first time to buy food, and it came to pass, when we came to the inn, that we opened our sacks, and behold, every man's money was in the mouth of his sack, our money in full weight, and we have brought it again in our hand. And other money have we brought down in our hands to buy food. We cannot tell who put our money in our sacks."
And he said,
"Peace be to you, fear not. Your God and the God of your father hath given you treasure in your sacks. I had your money."
And he brought Simeon out unto them. And the man brought the men into Joseph's house, and gave them water, and they washed their feet. And he gave their asses provender. And they made ready the present against Joseph came at noon, for they heard that they should eat bread there. And when Joseph came home, they brought him the present which was in their hand into the house, and bowed themselves to him to the earth. And he asked them of their welfare, and said,
"Is your father well, the old man of whom ye spake? Is he yet alive?"
And they answered,
"Thy servant, our father, is in good health. He is yet alive."
And they bowed down their heads and made obeisance. And he lifted up his eyes and saw his brother Benjamin, his mother's son, and said,
"Is this your younger brother, of whom ye spake unto me?"
And he said,
"God be gracious unto thee, my son."
And Joseph made haste, for his bowels did yearn upon his brother, and he sought where to weep, and he entered into his chamber and wept there. And he washed his face, and went out, and refrained himself, and said,
"Set on bread."
And they set on for him by himself, and for them by themselves, and for the Egyptians which did eat with him by themselves, because the Egyptians might not eat bread with the Hebrews, for that is an abomination unto the Egyptians. And they sat before him, the firstborn according to his birthright, and the youngest according to his youth. And the men marveled one at another. And he took and sent messes unto them from before him. But Benjamin's mess was 5 times so much as any of theirs. And they drank and were merry with him. Chapter 44. And he commanded the steward of his house, saying,
"Fill the men's sacks with food, as much as they can carry, and put every man's money in his sack's mouth, and put my cup, the silver cup, in the sack's mouth of the youngest, and his corn money."
And he did according to the word that Joseph had spoken. As soon as the morning was light, the men were sent away, they and their asses. And when they were gone out of the city, and not yet far off, Joseph said unto his steward,
"Up, follow after the men, and when thou dost overtake them, say unto them, Wherefore have ye rewarded evil for good? Is not this it in which my lord drinketh, and whereby indeed he divineth? Ye have done evil in so doing."
And he overtook them, and he spake unto them these same words. And they said unto him,
"Wherefore saith my lord these words? God forbid that thy servant should do according to this thing. Behold, the money which we found in our sacks' mouths, we brought again unto thee out of the land of Canaan. How then should we steal out of thy lord's house silver or gold? With whomsoever of thy servants it be found, both let him die, and we also will be my lord's bondmen."
And he said,
"Now also let it be according unto your words. He with whom it is found shall be my servant, and ye shall be blameless."
Then they speedily took down every man his sack to the ground, and opened every man his sack. And he searched, and began at the eldest, and left at the youngest. And the cup was found in Benjamin's sack. Then they rent their clothes, and laded every man his ass, and returned to the city. And Judah and his brethren came to Joseph's house, for he was yet there. And they fell before him on the ground. And Joseph said unto them,
"What deed is this that ye have done? Wot ye not that such a man as I can certainly divine?"
And Judah said,
"What shall we say unto my lord? What shall we speak? Or how shall we clear ourselves? God hath found out the iniquity of thy servants. Behold, we are my lord's servants, both we
and he also with whom the cup is found.
And he said,
God forbid that I should do so, but the man in whose hand the cup is found, he shall be my servant. And as for you, get you up in peace unto your father.
Then Judah came near unto him and said,
O my lord, let thy servant, I pray thee, speak a word in my lord's ears, and let not thine anger burn against thy servant, for thou art even as Pharaoh. My lord asked his servants, saying, Have ye a father or a brother? And we said unto my lord, We have a father, an old man, and a child of his old age, a little one. And his brother is dead, and he alone is left of his mother, and his father loveth him. And thou saidst unto thy servants, Bring him down unto me, that I may set mine eyes upon him. And we said unto my lord, The lad cannot leave his father. For if he should leave his father would die. And thou saidst unto thy servants, Except your youngest brother come down with you, ye shall see my face no more. And it came to pass, when we came up unto thy servant my father, we told him the words of my lord. And our father said, Go again and buy us a little food. And we said, We cannot go down. If our youngest brother be with us, then will we go down. For we may not see the man's face, except our youngest brother be with us. And thy servant my father said unto us, Ye know that my wife bare me two sons. And the one went out from me. And I said, Surely he is torn in pieces. And I saw him not since. And if ye take this also from me, and mischief befall him, ye shall bring down my gray hairs with sorrow to the grave. Now therefore, when I come to thy servant my father, and the lad be not with us, seeing that his life is bound up in the lad's life, it shall come to pass, when he seeth that the lad is not with us, that he will die. And thy servants shall bring down the gray hairs of thy servant our father with sorrow to the grave. For thy servant became surety for the lad unto my father, saying, If I bring him not unto thee, then I shall bear the blame to my father forever. Now therefore, I pray thee, let thy servant abide instead of the lad a bondman to my lord, and let the lad go up with his brethren. For how shall I go up to my father, and the lad be not with me, lest peradventure I see the evil that shall come on my father?
Chapter 45. Then Joseph could not refrain himself before all them that stood by him, and he cried,
Cause every man to go out from me.
And there stood no man with him while Joseph made himself known unto his brethren. And he wept aloud, and the Egyptians and the house of Pharaoh heard. And Joseph said unto his brethren,
I am Joseph. Doth my father yet live?
And his brethren could not answer him, for they were troubled at his presence. And Joseph said unto his brethren,
Come near to me, I pray you.
And they came near, and he said,
I am Joseph, your brother, whom ye sold into Egypt. Now, therefore, be not grieved, nor angry with yourselves, that ye sold me hither, for God did send me before you to preserve life. For these 2 years hath the famine been in the land, and yet there are 5 years, in the which there shall neither be earing nor harvest. And God sent me before you to preserve you a posterity in the earth, and to save your lives by a great deliverance. So now it was not you that sent me hither, but God. And he hath made me a father to Pharaoh, and lord of all his house, and a ruler throughout all the land of Egypt. Haste ye, and go up to my father, and say unto him, Thus saith thy son Joseph, God hath made me lord of all Egypt. Come down unto me, tarry not, and thou shalt dwell in the land of Goshen, and thou shalt be near unto me, thou and thy children, and thy children's children, and thy flocks, and thy herds, and all that thou hast. And there will I nourish thee. For yet there are 5 years of famine, lest thou and thy household, and all that thou hast, come to poverty. And behold, your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin, that it is my mouth that speaketh unto you. And ye shall tell my father of all my glory in Egypt, and of all that ye have seen. And ye shall haste, and bring down my father hither.
And he fell upon his brother Benjamin's neck, and wept. And Benjamin wept upon his neck. Moreover, he kissed all his brethren, and wept upon them. And after that his brethren talked with him. And the fame thereof was heard in Pharaoh's house, saying,
Joseph's brethren are come.
And it pleased Pharaoh well, and his servants. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph,
Say unto thy brethren, This do ye, lade your beasts, and go, get you into the land of Canaan, and take your father and your households, and come unto me, and I will give you the good of the land of Egypt. And ye shall eat the fat of the land. Now thou art commanded, This do ye, take you wagons out of the land of Egypt for your little ones, and for your wives, and bring your father, and come. Also regard not your stuff, for the good of all the land of Egypt is yours.
And the children of Israel did so. And Joseph gave them wagons according to the commandment of Pharaoh, and gave them provision for the way. To all of them he gave each man changes of raiment, but to Benjamin he gave 300 pieces of silver and 5 changes of raiment. And to his father he sent after this manner 10 asses laden with the good things of Egypt, and 10 she-asses laden with corn and bread and meat for his father by the way. So he sent his brethren away, and they departed, and he said unto them,
See that ye fall not out by the way.
And they went up out of Egypt, and came into the land of Canaan unto Jacob their father, and told him, saying,
Joseph is yet alive, and he is governor over all the land of Egypt.
And Jacob's heart fainted, for he believed them not. And they told him all the words of Joseph which he had said unto them. And when he saw the wagons which Joseph had sent to carry him, the spirit of Jacob their father revived. And Israel said,
It is enough. Joseph, my son, is yet alive. I will go and see him before I die.
Chapter 46. And Israel took his journey with all that he had, and came to Beersheba, and offered sacrifices unto the God of his father Isaac. And God spake unto Israel in the visions of the night, and said,
Jacob, Jacob.
And he said,
Here am I.
And he said,
I am God, the God of thy father. Fear not to go down into Egypt, for I will there make of thee a great nation. I will go down with thee into Egypt, and I will also surely bring thee up again, and Joseph shall put his hand upon thine eyes.
And Jacob rose up from Beersheba, and the sons of Israel carried Jacob their father and their little ones and their wives in the wagons which Pharaoh had sent to carry him. And they took their cattle and their goods which they had gotten in the land of Canaan, and came into Egypt. Jacob and all his seed with him, his sons and his sons' sons with him, his daughters and his sons' daughters, and all his seed brought he with him into Egypt. And these are the names of the children of Israel which came into Egypt: Jacob and his sons, Reuben, Jacob's firstborn, and the sons of Reuben, Hanok, and Phallu, and Hezron, and Carmi, and the sons of Simeon, Jemuel, and Janan, and Odad, and Jachin, and Zohar, and Shaul, the son of a Canaanitish woman, and the sons of Levi, Gershon, Kohath, and Merari, and the sons of Judah, and Onan, and Shelah, and Perez, and Zerah. But and Onan died in the land of Canaan. And the sons of Perez were Hezron, and Hamul, and the sons of Issachar, Tola, and Phuva, and Job, and Shimron. And the sons of Zebulun, Sirid, and Elon, and Jaleel. These be the sons of Leah, which she bare unto Jacob in Padan Aram, with his daughter Dinah. All the souls of his sons and his daughters were 33. And the sons of Gad, Ziphion, and Hagi, Shunai, and Esbon, Eri, and Aradai, and Areli. And the sons of Asher, Jimna, and Ishua, and Isui, and Beriah, and Sarah their sister. And the sons of Beriah, Heber, and Malkiel. These are the sons of Zilpah, whom Laban gave to Leah his daughter. And these she bare unto Jacob, even 16 souls, the sons of Rachel, Jacob's wife, Joseph, and Benjamin. And under Joseph in the land of Egypt were born Manasseh and Ephraim, which Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On, bare unto him. And the sons of Benjamin were Bela, and Beker, and Ashbel, Jerah, and Naaman, Ehi, and Rosh, Muppim, and Huppim, and Ard. These are the sons of Rachel, which were born to Jacob. All the souls were 14. And the sons of Dan, Hushim. And the sons of Naphtali, Jaziel, and Guni, and Jezer, and Shillem. These are the sons of Bilhah, which Laban gave unto Rachel his daughter, and she bare these unto Jacob. All the souls were 7. All the souls that came with Jacob into Egypt, which came out of his loins, besides Jacob's sons' wives, all the souls were 86. And the sons of Joseph, which were born him in Egypt, were 2 souls. All the souls of the house of Jacob, which came into Egypt, were 70. And he sent Judah before him unto Joseph, to direct his face unto Goshen. And they came into the land of Goshen, and Joseph made ready his chariot, and went up to meet Israel his father to Goshen, and presented himself unto him. And he fell on his neck, and wept on his neck a good while. And Israel said unto Joseph,
Now let me die, since I have seen thy face, because thou art yet alive.
And Joseph said unto his brethren, and unto his father's house,
I will go up, and show Pharaoh, and say unto him, My brethren and my father's house, which were in the land of Canaan, are come unto me. And the men are shepherds, for their trade hath been to feed cattle. And they have brought their flocks, and their herds, and all that they have. And it shall come to pass, when Pharaoh shall call you, and shall say, What is your occupation? That ye shall say, Thy servant's trade hath been about cattle from our youth, even until now, both we and also our fathers, that ye may dwell in the land of Goshen, for every shepherd is an abomination unto the Egyptians.
Chapter 47. Then Joseph came and told Pharaoh and said,
My father and my brethren and their flocks and their herds and all that they have are come out of the land of Canaan, and behold, they are in the land of Goshen.
And he took some of his brethren, even 5 men, and presented them unto Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said unto his brethren,
What is your occupation?
And they said unto Pharaoh,
Thy servants are shepherds, both we and also our fathers.
They said moreover unto Pharaoh,
For to sojourn in the land are we come, for thy servants have no pasture for their flocks, for the famine is sore in the land of Canaan. Now therefore, we pray thee, let thy servants dwell in the land of Goshen.
And Pharaoh spake unto Joseph, saying,
Thy father and thy brethren are come unto thee. The land of Egypt is before thee. In the best of the land make thy father and brethren to dwell. In the land of Goshen let them dwell. And if thou knowest any men of activity among them, then make them rulers over my cattle.
And Joseph brought in Jacob his father and set him before Pharaoh. And Jacob blessed Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said unto Jacob,
How old art thou?
And Jacob said unto Pharaoh,
The days of the years of my pilgrimage are 130 years. Few and evil have the days of the years of my life been, and have not attained unto the days of the years of the life of my fathers in the days of their pilgrimage.
And Jacob blessed Pharaoh, and went out from before Pharaoh. And Joseph placed his father and his brethren, and gave them a possession in the land of Egypt, in the best of the land, in the land of Ramesses, as Pharaoh had commanded. And Joseph nourished his father and his brethren and all his father's household with bread, according to their families. And there was no bread in all the land, for the famine was very sore, so that the land of Egypt and all the land of Canaan fainted by reason of the famine. And Joseph gathered up all the money that was found in the land of Egypt and in the land of Canaan for the corn which they bought. And Joseph brought the money into Pharaoh's house. And when money failed in the land of Egypt and in the land of Canaan, all the Egyptians came unto Joseph and said,
Give us bread, for why should we die in thy presence? For the money faileth.
And Joseph said,
Give your cattle, and I will give you for your cattle, if money fail.
And they brought their cattle unto Joseph. And Joseph gave them bread in exchange for horses, and for the flocks, and for the cattle of the herds, and for the asses. And he fed them with bread for all their cattle for that year. When that year was ended, they came unto him the second year and said unto him,
We will not hide it from my lord how that our money is spent. My lord also hath our herds of cattle. There is not aught left in the sight of my lord but our bodies and our lands. Wherefore shall we die before thine eyes, both we and our land?
Buy us and our land for bread, and we and our land will be servants unto Pharaoh. And give us seed that we may live and not die, that the land be not desolate.
And Joseph bought all the land of Egypt for Pharaoh, for the Egyptians sold every man his field, because the famine prevailed over them. So the land became Pharaoh's, and as for the people, he removed them to cities from one end of the borders of Egypt even to the other end thereof. Only the land of the priests bought he not, for the priests had a portion assigned them of Pharaoh, and did eat their portion which Pharaoh gave them. Wherefore they sold not their lands. Then Joseph said unto the people,
Behold, I have bought you this day and your land for Pharaoh. Lo, here is seed for you, and ye shall sow the land. And it shall come to pass in the increase, that ye shall give the fifth part unto Pharaoh, and 4 parts shall be your own.
for seed of the field, and for your food, and for them of your households, and for food for your little ones.
And they said,
Thou hast saved our lives. Let us find grace in the sight of my Lord, and we will be Pharaoh's servants.
And Joseph made it a law over the land of Egypt unto this day, that Pharaoh should have the fifth part, except the land of the priests only, which became not Pharaoh's. And Israel dwelt in the land of Egypt in the country of Goshen, and they had possessions therein, and grew and multiplied exceedingly. And Jacob lived in the land of Egypt 17 years, so the whole age of Jacob was 147 years. And the time drew nigh that Israel must die, and he called his son Joseph, and said unto him,
If now I have found grace in thy sight, put, I pray thee, thy hand under my thigh, and deal kindly and truly with me. Bury me not, I pray thee, in Egypt, but I will lie with my fathers, and thou shalt carry me out of Egypt, and bury me in their burying place.
And he said,
I will do as thou hast said.
And he said,
Swear unto me.
And he sware unto him. And Israel bowed himself upon the bed's head. Chapter 48. And it came to pass after these things that one told Joseph,
Behold, thy father is sick.
And he took with him his two sons, Manasseh and Ephraim. And one told Jacob and said,
Behold, thy son Joseph cometh unto thee.
And Israel strengthened himself and sat upon the bed. And Jacob said unto Joseph,
God Almighty appeared unto me at Luz in the land of Canaan, and blessed me, and said unto me, Behold, I will make thee fruitful, and multiply thee, and I will make of thee a multitude of people, and will give this land to thy seed after thee for an everlasting possession. And now thy two sons, Ephraim and Manasseh, which were born unto thee in the land of Egypt, before I came unto thee into Egypt, are mine. As Reuben and Simeon, they shall be mine, and thy issue, which thou begettest after them, shall be thine, and shall be called after the name of their brethren in their inheritance. And as for me, when I came from Paddan, Rachel died by me in the land of Canaan in the way, when yet there was but a little way to come unto Ephrath. And I buried her there in the way of Ephrath. The same is Bethlehem.
And Israel beheld Joseph's sons, and said,
Who are these?
And Joseph said unto his father,
They are my sons, whom God hath given me in this place.
And he said,
Bring them, I pray thee, unto me, and I will bless them.
Now the eyes of Israel were dim for age, so that he could not see. And he brought them near unto him, and he kissed them, and embraced them. And Israel said unto Joseph,
I had not thought to see thy face, and lo, God hath showed me also thy seed.
And Joseph brought them out from between his knees, and he bowed himself with his face to the earth. And Joseph took them both, Ephraim in his right hand toward Israel's left hand, and Manasseh in his left hand toward Israel's right hand, and brought them near unto him. And Israel stretched out his right hand and laid it upon Ephraim's head, who was the younger, and his left hand upon Manasseh's head, guiding his hands wittingly, for Manasseh was the firstborn. And he blessed Joseph and said,
God, before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac did walk, the God which fed me all my life long unto this day, the angel which redeemed me from all evil, bless the lads, and let my name be named on them, and the name of my fathers Abraham and Isaac, and let them grow into a multitude in the midst of the earth.
And when Joseph saw that his father laid his right hand upon the head of Ephraim, it displeased him, and he held up his father's hand to remove it from Ephraim's head unto Manasseh's head. And Joseph said unto his father,
Not so, my father, for this is the firstborn. Put thy right hand upon his head.
And his father refused and said,
I know it, my son, I know it. He also shall become a people, and he also shall be great, but truly, his younger brother shall be greater than he, and his seed shall become a multitude of nations.
And he blessed them that day, saying,
In thee shall Israel bless, saying, God make thee as Ephraim and as Manasseh.
And he set Ephraim before Manasseh, and Israel said unto Joseph,
Behold, I die, but God shall be with you, and bring you again unto the land of your fathers. Moreover, I have given to thee one portion above thy brethren, which I took out of the hand of the Amorite with my sword and with my bow.
Chapter 49. And Jacob called unto his sons and said,
Gather yourselves together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days. Gather yourselves together, and hear, ye sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel your father. Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity, and the excellency of power. Unstable as water, thou shalt not excel. Because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, then defiledst thou it. He went up to my couch. Simeon and Levi are brethren. Instruments of cruelty are in their habitations. O my soul, come not thou into their secret. Unto their assembly, mine honor, be not thou united. For in their anger they slew a man, and in their self-will they digged down a wall. Cursed be their anger, for it was fierce, and their wrath, for it was cruel. I will divide them in Jacob and scatter them in Israel. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thine enemies. Thy father's children shall bow down before thee. Judah is a lion's whelp. From the prey, my son, thou art gone up. He stooped down. He couched as a lion. And as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come. And unto him shall the gathering of the people be, binding his foal unto the vine, and his ass's colt unto the choice vine. He washed his garments in wine, and his clothes in the blood of grapes. His eyes shall be red with wine, and his teeth white with milk. Zebulun shall dwell at the haven of the sea, and he shall be for an haven of ships, and his border shall be unto Zidon. Issachar is a strong ass couching down between two burdens, and he saw that rest was good, and the land that it was pleasant, and bowed his shoulder to bear, and became a servant unto tribute. Dan shall judge his people as one of the tribes of Israel. Dan shall be a serpent by the way, an adder in the path that biteth the horse heels, so that his rider shall fall backward. I have waited for thy salvation, O Lord. Gad, a troop shall overcome him, but he shall overcome at the last. Out of Asher his bread shall be fat, and he shall yield royal dainties. Naphtali is a hind let loose. He giveth goodly words. Joseph is a fruitful bough, even a fruitful bough by a well, whose branches run over the wall. The archers have sorely grieved him, and shot at him, and hated him. But his bow abode in strength, and the arms of his hands were made strong by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob. From thence is the shepherd, the stone of Israel, even by the God of thy father, who shall help thee, and by the Almighty, who shall bless thee with blessings of heaven above, blessings of the deep that lieth under, blessings of the breasts and of the womb. The blessings of thy father have prevailed above the blessings of my progenitors, unto the utmost bound of the everlasting hills. They shall be on the head of Joseph, and on the crown of the head of him that was separate from his brethren. Benjamin shall raven as a wolf. In the morning he shall devour the prey, and at night he shall divide the spoil.
All these are the 12 tribes of Israel, and this is it that their father spake unto them, and blessed them. Every one according to his blessing he blessed them, and he charged them, and said unto them,
I am to be gathered unto my people. Bury me with my fathers in the cave that is in the field of Ephron the Hittite, in the cave that is in the field of Machpelah, which is before Mamre, in the land of Canaan, which Abraham bought with the field of Ephron the Hittite, for a possession of a burying place. There they buried Abraham and Sarah, his wife. There they buried Isaac and Rebekah, his wife. And there I buried Leah. The purchase of the field and of the cave that is therein was from the children of Heth.
And when Jacob had made an end of commanding his sons, he gathered up his feet into the bed, and yielded up the ghost, and was gathered unto his people. Chapter 50. And Joseph fell upon his father's face, and wept upon him, and kissed him. And Joseph commanded his servants, the physicians, to embalm his father. And the physicians embalmed Israel. And 40 days were fulfilled for him, for so are fulfilled the days of those which are embalmed. And the Egyptians mourned for him 70 days. And when the days of his mourning were past, Joseph spake unto the house of Pharaoh, saying,
If now I have found grace in your eyes, speak, I pray you, in the ears of Pharaoh, saying, My father made me swear, saying, Lo, I die in my grave which I have digged for me in the land of Canaan. There shalt thou bury me. Now therefore let me go up, I pray thee, and bury my father, and I will come again.
And Pharaoh said,
Go up and bury thy father, according as he made thee swear.
And Joseph went up to bury his father, and with him went up all the servants of Pharaoh, the elders of his house, and all the elders of the land of Egypt, and all the house of Joseph and his brethren and his father's house. Only their little ones and their flocks and their herds they left in the land of Goshen. And there went up with him both chariots and horsemen, and it was a very great company. And they came to the threshing floor of Atad, which is beyond Jordan, and there they mourned with a great and very sore lamentation. And he made a mourning for his father 7 days. And when the inhabitants of the land, the Canaanites, saw the mourning in the floor of Atad, they said,
This is a grievous mourning to the Egyptians.
Wherefore the name of it was called Abel Mizraim, which is beyond Jordan. And his sons did unto him according as he commanded them. For his sons carried him into the land of Canaan, and buried him in the cave of the field of Machpelah, which Abraham bought with the field for a possession of the burying place of Ephron the Hittite, before Mamre. And Joseph returned into Egypt, he and his brethren, and all that went up with him to bury his father, after he had buried his father. And when Joseph's brethren saw that their father was dead, they said,
Joseph will peradventure hate us, and will certainly requite us all the evil which we did unto him.
And they sent a messenger unto Joseph, saying,
Thy father did command before he died, saying, So shall ye say unto Joseph, Forgive, I pray thee now, the trespass of thy brethren and their sin, for they did unto thee evil. And now, we pray thee, forgive the trespass of the servants of the God of thy father.
And Joseph wept when they spake unto him, and his brethren also went and fell down before his face, and they said,
Behold, We be thy servants.
And Joseph said unto them,
Fear not, for am I in the place of God? But as for you, ye thought evil against me. But God meant it unto good, to bring to pass as it is this day, to save much people alive. Now therefore fear ye not, I will nourish you, and your little ones.
And he comforted them, and spake kindly unto them. And Joseph dwelt in Egypt, he and his father's house. And Joseph lived 110 years. And Joseph saw Ephraim's children of the third generation, the children also of Machir the son of Manasseh, were brought up upon Joseph's knees. And Joseph said unto his brethren,
I die, and God will surely visit you, and bring you out of this land unto the land which he sware to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob.
And Joseph took an oath of the children of Israel, saying,
God will surely visit you, and ye shall carry up my bones from hence.
So Joseph died, being 110 years old, and they embalmed him, and he was put in a coffin in Egypt.